the channel. Say during an interview you are given the head of a linked list and you are tasked to determine if this linked list has a cycle in it and return the node where the cycle starts. Take this list as an example. As you can see, the node 9 is linked back to node 4, forming a cycle. So, if there is some node in the list that can be reached again by continuously following the next node in the list, then this list has a cycle. One property we can extract from the list we see is that if a single linked list contains a cycle, then no matter how long we iterate over it, we will never reach a null node. And if you've watched our videos about linked lists, you know that the classic way to iterate over a linked list is by starting at the head node and keep hopping to the next node until we reach null. So if we do reach a null value and exit the while loop, then the list we traversed does not have a cycle. Another property is that if this list has a cycle, then while iterating over it, we will at some point hit the same node twice, and if we were storing or keeping track of the elements we traversed, then that node, the node where the cycle starts, would be the first duplicate element. Now, the first time I tried to approach this problem, my mind automatically jumped to sets and maps, as duplicates means sets. And if we were to store the values we are traversing inside the set, then hitting a duplicate element means we have a cycle. In Java, the add method will return false if that element was already in the set and hence is the element where the cycle starts. The code we just implemented while trying to explain the problem is efficient, runs in linear time, and will return the node where the cycle starts. However, usually the interviewer will scale this problem up and ask you to solve it without making use of extra space, without making use of that extra set. And to do that, we'll have to make use of Floyd's cycle detection algorithm, also known as the tortoise and hare algorithm, which is the subject of today's video. You see, this algorithm uses a similar approach to the two pointers technique we explained in one of our previous videos, and the main idea behind it is, just like before, two pointers moving at different speeds. For instance, take the same list we previously had, and let's place two pointers at its head node because that's all we have. One of these pointers, the slow one, will traverse the list normally by hopping one node at a time, whereas the second pointer, the fast one, will hop two nodes at a time. If we keep iterating, these two pointers are bound to meet if a cycle exists, and if a cycle doesn't exist, then the fast pointer will eventually reach null. To illustrate why this works in the most intuitive way, take the cycle you see in front of you. In each step of the algorithm, the slow pointer or tortoise will hop one node at a time, so it will move from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4, etc. And the fast pointer or hare will hop two nodes, in this example starting at node 2, it will move from 2 to 4 to 6 to 8, etc. You see, in practice, if one pointer is moving one unit and the second is moving two units, then it's just like in each step the tortoise stays stationary and the hare moves by one step, bringing them closer. As you can see, the distance between the two is reduced with every iteration until it is zero and they eventually meet. Now, implementing this algorithm is very easy. All you must do is create two pointers, as we mentioned, and move these pointers by hopping one or two nodes accordingly. While iterating, if these pointers meet, then we have a cycle. If we reach a null node, then we don't. Okay, the logic we wrote allows us to detect if a cycle exists optimally. But what about the second part? What about returning the node where the cycle starts, which in this example is 4? How do we return that? Well, after these pointers meet, if you move one of them back to the start of the list and set both pointers to hop one node at a time, then they will meet again at the node where the cycle begins. And this time, instead of just visualizing it, we are going to prove why this works mathematically. So, let x be the distance from the head to the start of the cycle, y the distance from the start of the cycle to the meeting point, and z the distance from the meeting point back to the start of the cycle. We can easily deduce that the distance traveled by the slow pointer before meeting is x plus y, and that the distance traveled by the fast pointer before meeting is x plus 2y plus z. Now, since the hare travels with double the speed of the tortoise and time is constant for both when they reach the meeting point, then by using the simple speed, time, and distance relation, we will get 2x plus y equals x plus 2y plus z, which can be simplified to 2x plus 2y equals x plus 2y plus z, meaning x equals z. So, by moving one of the pointers to the start of the list and making both pointers move one node at a time, they both will reach the node where the cycle begins after x or z nodes. Okay, to integrate this into our implementation, we need to break out of the while loop instead of returning true when the slow and fast pointers meet. Then, once out, we check if a cycle was the reason why the while loop terminated. So, if these pointers are not equal, we return null as no cycle was found. However, if they are equal, we move one of them back to the head, and while they are not equal again, these two pointers will jump one node at a time until they meet again at the node where the cycle starts. Finally, we can return any of these two nodes as they are now equal. With that, you get the complete implementation of the Floyd cycle detection algorithm. The links to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comment section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.